Hey y'all, I have a super quick video for you guys today that's been requested by a few different people, and that is how I organize my All About Reading program. Let's get into it. Welcome or welcome back to the channel. If you are new here, my name is Kaela. I'm so happy you stopped by. Feel free to check out the description box below to get to know a little bit more about me. I have a little bio down there. I would also love to get to know you better, so drop a comment and introduce yourself. If you love videos about homeschooling, mama life, and homemaking, make sure you subscribe to the channel because I have a lot more great videos coming your way. And make sure you turn notifications on so that you won't miss a thing. All right, y'all, let's jump right in. I love All About Reading. It is like one of my favorite things that we've ever used in our homeschool. When you buy All About Reading, you will receive a lot of different components and moving parts. If you buy the program used or secondhand, which by the way is a fantastic option to save a little bit of money on this program, but if you go and buy it secondhand through a Facebook resale group or eBay, it's important that you know what components are included typically in any given level. That way you can tell right away what is being sold and what you may potentially need to purchase elsewhere. So for any typical level of All About Reading, you will need or receive a teacher's guide. So this is for level two, just an example of the teacher's guide. This is going to have all of your lesson plans. It's scripted, which is really nice. If you have no foundation in teaching any child how to read, it tells you exactly what to say and what to do step by step for each lesson. I absolutely love the way that the teacher's guides are designed. I found them to be incredibly easy to implement, which is key for me. You will also receive your readers. Level one has three readers, and then for level two and level three, they both have two readers. I believe level four also has two readers. That's the only level that I don't have yet. And the pre-reader level will also have readers that are meant to be read by you, the parent, not by the child. But in every other level after that, from one, two, three, four, they're going to be reading these stories themselves. It's important to note that if you are buying this program used, make sure and check which edition every book is from. The older editions of All About Reading are going to be fully in black and white, and that includes your readers. The newer editions are in color. So I'll just show you for this one, we do have an older edition. All the illustrations are in black and white. For level three, I did actually buy that new and I got the full color version and my kids love that so much more. But that being said, they still really enjoy these readers even when the illustrations are in black and white. Just something for you to consider. Also, it's important to know what edition you're purchasing if you buy this secondhand, because there have been a few refinements over the years. And if you get a teacher's guide that's from 1 year and an activity guide that's from a different year, they might not correspond perfectly with each other. So just double check, be sure and ask. I have found that in the Facebook resale groups, they will have like a chart that kind of shows how you can align different editions of your activity book and your teacher's guide. So just feel free to ask them. They love talking about All About Reading, so I'm sure someone will be happy to answer your questions. Okay, so the activity book. I will put a picture here of the activity book because I don't have a physical one to show you, at least not in its original form, and that is what this video is about. Let me show you my activity books. I have our level one activity book in a binder, our level two activity book in a binder, and our level three activity book in a binder. So this is what this video is about, is organizing these activity books. And we will get to that in just a moment. There are two other key components to this program, and that is your letter tiles and your flashcards. So you have the option to buy the letter tiles in their physical form, Or alternatively, you can use the Letter Tiles app, which is super easy and awesome as an alternative. My kids actually like to use both depending on the day. The Letter Tiles are great if you have a kid who really does well with hands-on learning, with kinesthetic learning, with manipulatives. They're a lot of fun to use. The downside to using the Letter Tiles is they can get lost. They're very small. If you have a baby or a toddler, they might end up in someone's mouth. So be sure to consider your family, your kiddo, your overall lifestyle when you're making that choice, whether or not to get the physical Letter Tiles or just use the Letter Tiles app. With our Letter Tiles, I have them stored in the bottom left corner of our chalkboard. All About Reading does recommend using these on a magnetic whiteboard, and they even give you the specific dimensions of the whiteboard that will fit them the best and still give your child plenty of space to work with. However, I don't have a whiteboard. I don't use a whiteboard. I just have them on my magnetic chalkboard, and that works just as well for us. And then let's talk about the flashcards. So people do organize the flashcards in different ways. I have seen people put the flashcards in binders with the activity pages. So I'll show you what that looks like. Personally, I do not do that. I like to keep them in a box on our homeschool cart. All About Reading does sell storage boxes that are specifically designed to fit the flashcards for each level. However, they are on the pricey side for just a cardboard box. So I opted to use a little container like this. This was like maybe $2 at Walmart. It fits perfectly on my homeschool cart. I have one for each of my kiddo on their shelf on our homeschool cart, and I have everything that they need for any given subject that's particular to what they're learning in these little boxes. So this is for my kindergartner. She has her All About Reading flashcards for level one. And then she also has like some math manipulatives and some little cards in here that she uses for reading and for math. It's all just in one place, so we can easily grab this when I'm doing our one-on-one lesson time. Your yellow cards are individual phonogram cards. So these are specific letters with all of the sounds that they make listed on the back of the card. And then you have your green cards, which are the word cards. So these are words that they're going to be learning and hopefully able to recognize quickly on sight with the help of the flashcard practice. Your tab dividers are going to have a tab for phonogram cards that you need to review, phonogram cards for future lessons, and phonogram cards that are mastered. And then you'll have those same categories for the word cards. The great thing about the cards is at the bottom of the card, it will tell you what level and what lesson number this card is used or is introduced in. And that's true of the word cards as well. So that is why a lot of people choose to actually divide up their cards by lesson number and put them in their binder or their folders where their activity pages are, so that they can easily just grab everything for lesson 20 or lesson 40, and it's all right there in one place. The reason why I choose to keep these separate in their own box is that sometimes we are reviewing cards from other lessons that are not the lesson we're doing that day. So we might be reviewing a phonogram or a word from lesson 10, but we are actually using lesson 13 in the book. It doesn't make much sense for me to put them by lesson number as I would the activity pages. I hope that's clear. Feel free to ask me questions in the comments, and I will happily answer all of your questions if I am not making that much sense. But that is the way that I use the cards. So you definitely have the option of dividing these up by lesson or keeping them in a box. You can get the storage box from All About Reading, or you can just use your own box that's way cheaper. Okay, so the big part where the organization comes in is in your activity book. So let me just show you. This is the size of the activity book. This is the cover that I just chopped off to stick inside the sleeve cover of my binder. The activity book is super thick because it is chock full of pages that you are going to be using for each of your reading lessons. So let's talk about what those pages look like. I'm just going to show you one example. So for All About Reading Level 3, this is Lesson 2, you will have a practice sheet like this. Sometimes these are labeled fluency sheets. Basically, they're going to be lists of words that correspond to that lesson. Sometimes they will also have phrases or sentences that correspond with the lesson. The great thing about these pages in the activity book is they're perforated, so you can rip them out really easily. Alternatively, you could take the activity book to an office supply store and get the spine of the book chopped off. That would be a lot easier. Personally, I chose the more difficult route and I took all of these pages out manually. But again, they are perforated, so it's not that hard to do. It is very time consuming. And then for that same lesson, for lesson 2, we had an additional sheet. This is half of it, right? Same size as this, but you are supposed to cut out just this small picture. The other half of the page was a grid of little piggies that we have cut out, and on the back of those are words. So these are all for an activity that you would do in that lesson. And again, these come as just a page in the activity book, and you have to actually cut them up to be able to use them the way that they're designed to be used. Now, you can definitely do this with just a pair of scissors. My favorite tool to use when I'm prepping All About Reading is one of these paper slicers. It just makes it so much easier and faster to cut everything and make sure you get a nice clean edge, and it saves your hand from cramping up. So I definitely recommend having one of these if you don't already. When I am done cutting and prepping everything for any given lesson, I will slide it into a page protector like this. So I will literally put every single component for that lesson into the page protector. They are labeled with their lesson number, which is very helpful. But for these little pieces right here, where you're cutting them out of the paper that has the label, you might want to just mark on the back of those level 3, lesson 2, just in case they get misplaced, you will know where they are supposed to go back to. All right, so I'm going to turn the camera around and just show you what this binder setup looks like when it is completed so that you get an idea. So this is my finished binder for level 3 of All About Reading. Since I've taken apart this activity book completely, I can just slide the cover into this front sleeve. I've even seen mamas slide the spine of the activity book into the spine of their binder, which I think is a really smart idea. Unfortunately, I did not think to do that when I was prepping these. I did go ahead and keep the publisher page of the activity book, and I just slid it into this pocket in the inside. This will help me to know if I ever need to resell this, which edition I have, so that I can go ahead and let the mama who's buying it know which edition they are buying. Like I said, that's kind of important so that they can match up corresponding editions. I definitely prefer the binder that has the rings on the back side rather than on the spine. And this is a 2-inch binder, which just fits. Like, you could definitely use a 3-inch binder and have a little bit more wiggle room, but the 2-inch works exactly and perfectly with very little room to spare. So keep that in mind. And then we just start with all of our page protectors. So this is for lesson 1. When I am going to use this, I can easily just pop out this one sleeve. And I have everything that I need for that lesson. I have all my little cutouts, my activity, everything ready to go. So I will just give you a quick little gander at what this looks like. Another thing that you're going to see in the activity books are these little word flipper books. Again, these are going to be on a full page of paper until you cut and separate all the parts, but they are exactly what they sound like. They are word flipper books that are meant to be stapled together, and they will mark what is meant to be cut with a dash line and what is meant to be stapled with a little picture of a staple. So that makes it super easy to see exactly what you're doing. The straight edge paper cutter helps me to line these up a lot better than if I were cutting them with scissors by hand. It's very helpful to mark on the back what lesson little things like this go with, just in case they get misplaced or lost. So here I just wrote AAR3-8. That helps me know this is for All About Reading Level 3, Lesson 8. Here's another example of an activity page that you're going to see with All About Reading. You will sometimes have pages like this where they only have a dash line in the middle of the page. And the way that those are supposed to be cut is to make a slot. In this case, with this activity, your child is dividing up peanuts for the elephant, whether they are vowel suffixes or consonant suffixes. And so those little words are meant to be actually slid into the slot. The way that I cut these is with a pocket knife. You could also use an X-Acto knife or a box cutter. Just make sure that you're doing it safely on a safe surface. These are a little bit tricky. Thankfully, there's not too many of them. So you won't see them very frequently, but you will see them in each level. My kids absolutely love these slotted activity pages. They think they're super fun. So clearly, they are designed with the kiddos in mind. A little bit difficult to prep, but totally worth it. The last thing that I want to show you is in my binders, when we are using them, I will go ahead and use one of these sturdy binder dividers. You can get these almost anywhere, Target, Walmart, office supply stores, Amazon. They're usually tabbed, which makes them easy to grab and find. The way that I use this is to split up lessons we have already done from lessons that we still need to do. Whenever I pull this binder down, I can easily find where we are and what lessons I need to grab next. Which leads me to my last point. I do not keep these binders readily available on our homeschool cart. I have these up on our bookshelf. So I typically will pull these down once a week when I'm doing my homeschool prep for the week. I will grab typically two or three of these because that's how many lessons my daughters usually get through in a week. For my second grader, it could be anywhere from 3 to 5. For my kindergartner, it's usually only 1 or 2 lessons. So I will just grab the next little chunk of lessons that we have. I will just take those out and put them on our homeschool cart with my teacher's guide. I typically will just like stick them inside the book with our next lesson that we're going to be doing. And that way, when I go to grab this off of the cart, it already has my next activity pages ready to go. And I don't need to keep this big, bulky binder on the homeschool cart because, frankly, there's no way I could make it fit. These binders do take up quite a bit of shelf space, so it's helpful if I only have to pull them down once a week as opposed to every day. I want to be very clear that the worst part of All About Reading, by far, is prepping the activity book. Not because it's extremely difficult, but because of how time-consuming it is. So for me personally, I like to have all of it prepped for the whole level at once, rather than prepping activity pages each week or each day by lesson. That could never work for me. I could never do that. It's a lot easier for me to just sit down in between school terms, during our break, and prep an entire level. And typically, it will take a couple of days, if I'm being honest. I haven't actually timed it, but I feel like it's probably several hours to prep the activity book. And so normally I will do that over a period of a weekend or maybe even a few weekends if I only have short blocks of time available. It's a lot. It takes a lot of time. However, I stand by the fact that it is completely worth it to prep it all at once, get it done, then you have your whole level prepped for the duration that you're using that level, which might be a whole school year or maybe half a school year, you won't have to worry about any prep work for your reading lessons, and then it becomes very much open and go. If you would like to actually see this in practice and see me prep an entire level, let me know in the comments below. I don't have level 4 yet. I'm planning on buying it in the next couple of months, and I would be happy to make a video showing you guys me prepping that activity book from start to finish, if that's something that you're interested in. If you enjoyed this video or found it helpful, please don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. Make sure you're subscribed and have notifications on for the next video. I will see you guys then. Bye-bye.